Hi, everybody. This is Terry Weigel with your Thursday's Thoughts. We're going to talk today about something, since it's the beginning of the year, something that is that we implemented with our private clients, the people who teach us to mentor them. And we recently held a meeting, so I'm going to share with you one of the activities that we did. And I can almost guarantee you it's going to increase your productivity by at least 10 to 15%. We were amazed at the results. And all it was a simple little 20-minute activity, if you will. So what we did was, and here's the best part is, it's something you can do and it doesn't cost you a dime, okay? But think about that. 10 to 15% increase in productivity and it doesn't cost you a dime, okay? All you have to do, get out a piece of paper and a pen. At the top of the paper, write 8, skip a line 9, all the way up to 12, and then start over at 1, skip a line 2, skip a line 3, all the way to 10 o'clock. So what you've basically done is you have created yourself a timeline. Now in that timeline, what I need you to do, write down what you do during each one of those hours. So from 8 to 9, what do you do? 10 to 11, what is it that you do? Now, I know, this sounds like, basic stuff. We were amazed at the results. We all did it. We were amazed at the results. When you do that, all of a sudden you get a critical look at what it is that you're doing on a day-to-day activity that is not making you money, that is a time vampire. It's a time waster. Here's what we found. We found some people who were so in tune to looking up every little aspect of a house before they even knew if they were dealing with a motivated seller. We had people, and amazingly, when you start to look at the number of times you do that because you're getting a lot of calls in, it's a huge time robber. Why not just find out if the seller's motivated? Talk to them. Find out what it is that they're trying to do, and then do your due diligence. At least find out if you're talking with somebody who might even be interested in selling the house and what you need to get it for, or the ballpark area of what you need to get it for. Found some people who were spending 3 to 4 hours a day, Monday through Friday, driving neighborhoods. Well, the problem is that when you do that, all of a sudden you find out that you're not doing any follow-up on those neighborhoods. You're not doing anything that's designed to make you money. That's what this game is about. The other thing that we found out is some people were so in tune to go into meetings every week, like where I'm at in the Houston area, our local investment club. You could literally be at a meeting every single night and Saturday and most of the time on Sunday. Problem is, that doesn't leave you a lot of time to do any investing. So take a look at what it is that you're doing and how you're doing it from a very critical standpoint, and see what time vampires, the thing that just sucked the productivity right out of you, see what you can eliminate, see what you can get rid of. We did that for our clients, and I can almost guarantee you, if they go out and implement, if they go out and do the things that we talked about, they're going to increase their productivity by 10 to 15%, and so can you. Look, it takes 21 days to form a habit. So you got to start this and you got to take a critical look at the things that take it away. Hey, I take my daughter to school in the morning. I walk my dog in the morning. I know I have those things. So those are things that they're set in stone. I'm going to do those particular things. I'm going to spend time with my children. I'm going to spend time with my wife. I'm going to spend time with my dog. But I'm taking a very critical look at what I'm doing the rest of the time. Here's another little example, a little tidbit for you, last little tip that I'll leave you with, and that is this. Don't check your email first thing in the morning. Set up a specific time to check it. In the morning, you're at your most productive, the majority of the people. Don't get me wrong, there are some night owls that, they don't even begin to wake up until 6 o'clock at night. That's okay. There are some people, for the majority of the people, you're at your most productive state of mind in the morning. And if you hop on the email, what you find is all of a sudden you're going from here to there to there to there to there. You're not getting anything done. I mean, as much as an hour or 2 hours can slip away from you. And if you're doing emails when you're at your most productive, that's not making you money. So do this. Set it aside till about 11 o'clock. Maybe set it aside to 11 o'clock and 4 o'clock if you can. or 11 o'clock and 2 o'clock. One of those time frames, something like that, so that you can give it the due attention it deserves, but you're also spending your time doing the things that make you active. That when you're active, the things that are designed to make you money in real estate. Okay? I know this is a simple, basic thing, but I guarantee you that if you take the time, if you take a few minutes, you go and you do this little activity, you will be amazed at the results. And your productivity will go up 10 to 15%. Remember, it takes 21 days to get that little habit ingrained in your head. But once it's ingrained in your head, you'll start looking at things and going, is this making me money in real estate? If not, do I really need to be doing it right now? Or can I have somebody else do it? Can I have somebody else take over this function? Can I have somebody else go make that drive across town? Can I have somebody else pull the comps? Can I have somebody else do the mail out for me? What are the things that other people can do that you don't have to do? This has been Terry Weigel with your Thursday's Thoughts. Talk to you next week. Now go get a house. See you then.